Prophet Uba Ende talks about rap music. And when he was talking about rap music, he was talking about the old times rap. And he loved it. Many men of God even loved it. He shared a testimony. But now, what is really going on with rap music? Let's watch what the prophet is going to say. Go.
Here is the issue. Oh, yes. I want you to understand, here is the issue with our black people in America so that we understand it.
Yes, sir.
In the early stages of the music, when we're talking about rap music, you get the point.
Oh, yes, sir.
It was full of messages. Mm. Our people, emancipation from poverty into prosperity.
Oh, yes.
Black people thinking for themselves.
Yes, sir.
Mm. Black people requiring their own nation.
Oh, yes, sir.
Whatever, whether that dream was crazy or not, the fact is it gave people a certain level of power.
Oh, yes, sir.
And the white community in America noticed it. And realized something was wrong with the message, with the rap music that they were listening to. I know you're thinking, he has gone to rap music? Let me show you something. You understand Elijah Muhammad of the Nation of Islam?
Oh, yes.
Do you know what he said? He said, one rap song is more powerful than 1,000 of my sermons.
Wow, one rap song?
Yes, one rap song. He knew the impact of that one rap song. And the white community understood it. And turned the whole rap music that was giving black people desire to own things, emancipation, political, financial emancipation, economic emancipation, and gave them the power and the will to drive forward. They noticed it and changed through record companies and signing and saying, oh, this song, we don't like that song. We don't like this song. Until we started singing of our women as female dogs. This is not a vulgar word. Bitch is not a vulgar word.
Oh, yes.
That's a female dog.
Yes, sir. Very true, sir. Very true, sir. It's not.
How are we excited calling our women that name?
A female dog.
Yes. And our female also sing same songs, calling themselves female dogs themselves.
Hey.
Some even put on social media and write their name.
Hey. Hey.
Why? They knew. And we started calling our women's bodies booty. Do you know what it was? That was the hole underneath the ship that kept the slaves during slave transportation from Africa.
Whoa.
That was the booty. Now we're calling our women's bodies
booty. Wow. What is wrong?
I don't know if you're getting this.
What is wrong?
We're getting it, sir.
We're getting it, sir. We're getting it.
We're getting it.
According to Oxford Dictionary, as you see it online there, the term bitch comes from the old English word bais or a bitch, which means female dog. And that's the word that they are now using in their songs to refer to our women, to our queens. We're not calling white women that. We're calling our own that.
Our own,
We lost the moral fiber.
That's right.
And it is a planned thing so that America can fall.
Hey.
I know you're not hearing what we're talking about.
We're getting it.
Now that week, Thanksgiving week, is more powerful than Christmas now. More celebrated than Easter. They replaced deaths and put something that everyone will agree with and lift what God was saying. What are we doing? Is one America just going for a fall?
It's falling.
Here it is. Prophet Uba Angel is just spilling out truths here. And I have an evidence that I have one pal in, and if I mean pal, I mean friend, in America, United States to be precise. And we were talking about music that he grew up listening to. He's a bit of age. He's a friend, you know. And he was like, I was like, okay, I like to hear rap music as well. More of an African rap music and a bit of what goes on in America. And he was like, you know what? When he was coming up, rap music in those days was very rich in content, in substance. But now it is all bullshit and crap. And I was like, what is this man saying? Yes, what Prophet Uba Angel is also saying. That a whole preacher says a deep rap music in those days have more weight than his sermon. And now if you listen to rap music, it's about bullshit. I have this, I have that. I literally told a friend, a trader friend, and those of you guys who watch my other channel, I'm having a video that is coming up on that I saw the video with my friend, that friend that I'm talking about. I was telling him, you know, I don't listen to rap music in America because it's all, there's no substance, bro. All they say is bitches, a whole lot of bullshit. Money, millions, billions, bullshit. Cars and no bullshit. No substance. No substance. No substance. Unlike the days of Tupac, Biggie, we had substance. And some big record holders, we had substance. Not this, bro. So this is Prophet Uba Angel's stand, and I agree with him on rap music and how it has been influenced with record labels. I'm even forgetting to mention that. That's very important. Record label. Even these African Afrobeats guys signed to big record label, they have influence on the song that you release. They're like, nah, this is not coming out. The ones that is making more sense is not coming out. And Burna Boy coming up when he was just breaking out to the international space. I watched one particular podcast that he had with some American guys, and he was like, now, the money that my record label signed me with is still in the bank. The moment they try to infringe upon my privacy, infringe upon my rights, infringe upon what I want, I'm just withdrawing the money, giving it to them back, and we end the contract. Because he wants that freedom with his content, with his substance, in his music. So we have a popular saying in Africa that they sold their soul. The guy sold his soul. He signed a contract that he sold himself out. He sold everything out. Guys, if you love this one, I love to break down gospel messages like this. If you love it, make sure to subscribe, share, and like this video. I'm out.